fought Russia's ass right now, that you would hear. That those prayers are being answered, Lord God. It is a tangible way, Father. I believe you'll reveal it to him, Lord God, even before he leaves, Lord God. In Jesus' name.
As we continue to worship, let's refocus on Jesus. We'll be dismissing in just a couple minutes, but I would just encourage us to lean in for the next couple minutes. I don't know about you, but when Jesus' presence is palpable, I want like every last drop.
Come on!
Even if you have 99%, I would encourage us to push for the next. I've had this vision. I hope I get to share a little more, but I had a vision of all of you guys being thieves and robbing whatever God is doing here, like coal, just robbing. Because we're not running out. So be a thief, be a robber. Rob us coal and take it back whenever you go. And deposit it wherever you're going. Rob us coal. Challenge. In 20 minutes, I'm going to be back up here. We're going to give some housekeeping, but for the next 20 minutes, Psalm 34:8, taste and see. Taste and see. The Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. Will you taste and see? If you have not tasted and seen, lean in. If there's something on the table you want to taste and see, try it now. Okay? No rock stars here. This event is not the rock star. We are experiencing Jesus together.
Come on.
We're experiencing Jesus together. I don't know about you, but I've tasted and seen that the Lord is good. What about you?
Thank you.
as we continue to be good guests at a beautiful university that's being good hosts, and as we continue to champion the Forerunners Gen Z, we also want to champion sustainability, because as long as he's sitting at the table, I want to eat. But sometimes that requires sleep. And sometimes that requires amazing safety officers that are watching out for us. So let's just hear it for everyone who's here. There's some new things going on tonight that might feel a little bit like whiplash, but it's not whiplash. It's building the tracks. I don't know about you. I've never done this before. So we're still building the tracks for sustainability. So just for your information, we have been worshiping through the night congregationally. We will be closing Hughes down at 1 a.m. Guys, it's okay. Jesus and the Holy Spirit will be here when the doors get unlocked, okay? We will have some faithful worship leaders who are ministering to Jesus throughout the night. But we're going to close this, and this is for your safety and our sustainability. We'll open back up at noon tomorrow. I know this is new, but I've been here for a couple days, and God is generous when I sleep in and hang out with my girls for a little bit. God is generous when I leave early and take my wife to Sonic. He's going to continue to pour out. So do not be afraid. We are not quenching the Spirit. I don't believe we are. Substantially smarter than I, that think these things out. We should be grateful. There's some administrators here who have been working tirelessly to champion the health and safety, but also the sustainability of an outpouring of God. So let's hear it for the administration. Yeah. If you are 25 or younger, we have created a new expression that will be open right now until 2 a.m. called Abide, which will be a more simpler prayer room. So if we close at 1 and you're 25 and under and say, I want to keep on pouring out perfume, I want to keep on pouring out, I want to keep on praying, I want to keep on ministering, then ask one of our ushers, and they'll get you to Abide, the prayer room. Okay? You with me? College students, young adults? Other than that, we're going to close at 1 for sustainability and safety. We're going to be back at 12. You can be, hey, there's no rock stars up here. There's no divide line. We really have to ask the Lord and get on our faces as leadership. We really have to figure out how do we keep this safe and sustainable. So would you be praying for the leadership? Not because we're brilliant. We are ordinary people who've met with Jesus. But we really... We're going lower, so he's made it higher. And some of that lowness is being submitted to him and saying, how do we take care of kids? How do we take care of these families? So, would you pray for us tomorrow morning? We have a long meeting to say, how do we steward this? We want to hear the voice of God. We don't want to get in front of a whiteboard. We want to hear the voice of God, which might require some whiteboarding, but I don't know. So, let me say, 1 a.m., 25 or younger, there's a prayer room. We'll continue to minister. We're going to continue to worship until 1 a.m. And I do want to commission you, because this will be the last time you hear from me for a little bit. If you have tasted and seen the Lord is good, then the people of Wilmore, the people in the surrounding areas, the people at the airport as you fly home, the people at the gas stations as you drive home, your family members, your co-workers, should experience radical humility in the kindness of God. Yeah. If you come here to just eat and eat and eat and not exercise God's goodness, then you've come here to get fat. So burn calories in loving others, loving the lost, serving the lost, talking over one another and serving and loving. And that doesn't have to be like in your face, your barista, in your face, your gas attendant, okay? Christ's kindness, heart for the lost, on mission. But we don't have to think about that just yet, because we're going to continue to minister to Jesus, experience his ministry to us, we'll be the object of God's mission and agent of God's mission. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. Let's worship. Thank you.
Yes, Jesus. More Jesus. More Jesus.
Let our hearts not grow cold. Let our hearts not grow cold. Let my voice be heard. Let me not be an echo. Let me sing the song that He loves me. He loves me. He loves me. Even when I don't feel heard, He loves me. Even when I don't feel seen, He loves me. He loves me. He loves me. When I'm in my room alone and I just can't shake those thoughts, and I just feel sad and I just feel depressed, He still loves me. He still loves me. You see a sky, and you still love me, and you still love me. And we say thank you to that. We say thank you to that. That in my sin you still love me, but you're not done with me. You're not done with me.
Yeah.
You're not done with me. Yeah. This is just the beginning. This is just the beginning. Goodbye, my heart's to love, to love. Because you loved us first. And we sing that again. Yeah, He loves us.
Yeah.
Oh, how He loves us.
Oh, how He loves us. Oh, how He loves us. Oh, how He sing the song. Oh, He loves us. Oh, how He loves us. She
Yahweh,
word is holy and precious to Jesus. So maybe a couple of people have a verse on their heart that they can just speak out what we've been doing as a community. Whoever reads it out will say it's the word of God, then the community will respond and we believe it. Got it? All right, I'm going to start us off. Let's listen, okay? If you guys want to socialize things, awesome. There's friendships happening. We've had people reconcile, like pastors walk across the road to another pastor that they tell the rest on. It's beautiful. We're going to continue to keep this focus on Jesus. So I'm going to read Isaiah 55, and maybe three or four people after that. It's an invitation. Is anyone thirsty? Come and drink. Even if you have no money, come take your choice of wine or milk. It's all free. Why spend your money on food that does not give you strength? Why pay for food that does not do you any good? Listen to me and you'll eat what is good. You'll enjoy the finest food. Everyone in this room, God is saying, come to me with your ears wide open. Listen and you will find life. I will make you an everlasting covenant. I will give you unfailing love. I promise you. See how I use it. Your ancestors to display my power among the people. I made him a leader among the nations. May that be so. You will also command nations that you do not know. People unknown to you will come running to obey, because I, the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, have made you Lord. So that be so. That the nations will run to you because they've seen what's happened in your life. Now I'm preaching, I got it. You are. Seek the Lord while you can find him. Call on him now while he is near. Let the wicked change their ways and vanish their very follow through wrong. Let them turn to the Lord that he may have mercy on them. Yes, turn to our God, for he forgives generously. My thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, says the Lord. My ways are far beyond yours, anything that you can imagine. For just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways. My thoughts are higher than yours. The rain and snow come down from the heavens and stay on the ground to water the earth. It causes the grains to grow, producing seed for the farmer and bread for the hungry. It's the same with my word. Some of you guys need to know this. His word will not return void. I send it out, God says, and it will always produce fruit. It will accomplish all I want to. It will prosper everywhere I send it. You guys need to know this. You will live in joy and peace. The mountains and hills will burst into song. The trees of the field will clap their hands. Where once there were thorns, cypress trees will go, where there are nettles and myrtles will sprout out. These events will bring great honor to the Lord's name. It will be an everlasting sign of his power and love. Will these events bring great honor not to Asbury, not to a name, besides the Lord's name? And that you see a sign of an everlasting power and love. This is the word of God. Alright, three or four more. You just gotta stand up and tie and not like. Yeah, tie.
1 Peter 4, 8, 10. Above all, keep loving one another earnestly, since love covers the multitude of sins. Show hospitality to one another without grumbling. As each has received a gift, use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's very grace.
This is the word of God.
Thank you.
the word of God.
We believe.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh,
watch the video, a 12-second video of you guys worshiping. They went back to the village, showed the Jesus Dome, and the whole village came to Christ.
Come on!
Up to 500 at one point.
Wow. Yeah, there is. Yeah.